All right, guys, I'm back. I kind of figured out some of my problems. I went ahead and picked up a 12 amp, 6 volt battery. Actually, I picked up two. They really weren't that expensive, and I suspected my power supply was part of the problem. Actually, as it turned out, it was. In fact, it was a big part of the problem. But anyway, so I went ahead and hooked it up, and then while I was down there, I actually picked up a 0.47 capacitor, and the original schematic to bypass the interstage transformer called for a 2-watt 27k resistor, and I only had a 1-watt. It proved to be fine, and it wasn't even getting warm, but while I was down there, I picked up a 3-watt 27k. So I went ahead and wired that in there. I've been playing around inside the radio with different configurations. The way this was wired in the beginning was it had two positives and two negatives that went all the way back to the battery. And as I was messing around, I didn't think that was going to make a difference since they were, you know, the wires were still connected. I've been butchering this for wire parts. As it turns out, it did make a difference. And like I said, I was playing around with the wiring today. I basically completely separated the 6 volt power going to the power supply and to the other part that goes to the filaments, and completely separating them out turned out not to work. So I went ahead and jumpered them back together. So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to order red braided and black braided wire. I actually found a new place. I usually go with Sundial, but Sundial is I think $1.40 a foot, and I actually found another place, and I'm pulling up the website because I can't remember the name of it now. It's called grandbrass.com, and it's an antique lighting and electrical appliance restoration site. They basically, I'm just assuming it's the same wire as Sundial carries, but it's only a dollar a foot. Or excuse me, it's $1.25 for the cotton and $1 per foot for the rayon covered. So I'm going to go ahead and go with cotton. The other thing too is they have a lot more colors. They also have more antique plug options. I like to use the ivory antique plugs, which the acorn, the button plugs, but Sundial no longer carries them. They said the manufacturer isn't making them. I go over to this grandbrass.com, and they don't have the button ones, but they have Bakelite or Plascon, whatever, plastic, ivory ones that have, they're not the button kind, but they have like a little handle to pull them off. You can also stuff more of the cloth wire into the shaft so you can hide your little, where you put the fabric, tape up the fabric so it doesn't fray. Anyhow, so I'm going to go ahead and order from them, and then just go ahead and wire. I'll braid the two braids together and hook it up that way. I bought two of these batteries. I'll hook them up in parallel. As it turns out, I have an RC. One of my little hobbies was radio control cars, the expensive ones, not the $20 ones. And as it turns out, the smart charger I use for the lithium, the nickel metal hydride batteries for the RC cars also will charge up to 50 amp lead acid batteries. Plus, it's computer controlled, so it monitors the battery and it tapers off the charge, and I can set it to according to the manufacturer's recommendations. Anyway, be that as it may, I have a way to charge. So I can hook them up in parallel, and I think I'm going to put them in a wooden box. So I've got several of those little basswood boxes. And I've got one that's kind of rectangular shape and about the size of a car battery, so I was thinking about mocking that up. Anyway, be that as it may, I wanted to show you that this is working. I do still have, I'm getting vibrator hash in the speaker, and I'm going to play around with the filter caps. I'll bring this over closer so you can hear that. Make sure none of the wires are touching. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and power it up. And you can see the light this way, I think. Let's turn this light off. All right. So can you hear the hash, I think? So there's the hash. That's with it just turned on. Oops, I accidentally pressed the pause button. I'm a mess. Alright, alright, well, I'm gonna go ahead and turn it up. As you can tell, it's a bit bright, but I'm sure it'll sound a little bit better in the cabinet. I guess I shouldn't be talking over it. And the tone control is working. As for the issues that... I said I didn't have any plate voltage on the 32 tube, and then I thought about that again. And I thought that's not possible because the plate radio wouldn't play. And I was... I'm laughing because, you know, I did, as other people have mentioned, a lot of times we do this stuff late at night, and, you know I have, because you see my videos show up at like 2 o'clock in the morning. Anyways, I was testing the wrong pin. So I do have, everything's got, you know, voltages. I got some of the voltages are a little bit high. I'm not sure I'm going to worry too much about it. Like on the 32 tube, I'm getting, it's over about 7 or 8 volts. And that could be because of the meter not weighing down the circuit. But anyway, it's playing. I'm going to play around with the filter caps. I'm not really sure where to start. I guess I'll try starting in the power supply. When you turn the music up, you really can't hear it. But I must admit this is it. However, when it gets to a low spot in the music, you can hear it buzzing. So I guess I'll start in the power supply. It's got the 8 microfarad electrolytics in there, and I can bump it up, I guess, to 12 or 16, see how that works. Unless anybody has a better suggestion. I'll start there and work my way out. I guess there's really only 1, 2, 3, 4. There's only 5, so one way or another, I'm going to figure out what's what. And, so I guess this is working, and I'll see if I can improve it. But otherwise, anyway, otherwise it works. And let's see here. So you can see the dial light this way. And the dial light isn't pulsing anymore. Like I said, that's all had to do with the power supply and as I relearn electronics, I'll guess I'll figure that out. Anyhow, so I'm gonna start working on the cabinet. I've been kind of dreading that because it's such a mess, but I'll do a video on the cabinet, and I don't know if you guys have caught Dennis's latest video, but apparently, since I was mentioned in there, I guess the next project will be, electronically speaking, will be to troubleshoot that 4125. I wanted to work on another couple radios as I read more and learn more, and I have a better idea of, you know, how things work inside of a radio now. I mean, I always had a concept of how the circuits work, but being actually inside of a radio, especially this one, I've gotten a little bit better. So we'll go ahead and take a look at that. And again, the next video, I guess, will be for on this one. The next video will be the results of trying to filter out this last bit of hash, and then we'll work on the cabinet. But anyway, I wanted to thank you guys for watching, and I'll quit my babbling, and maybe I'll just turn this on. You can listen to a little bit of music. Find a better station. Did she just say jackass? I won't bore you anymore with that, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, and have a great weekend.